Let me welcome Honorable Minister for Railways, Sri Suresh Prabhuji.
मैं सदस्य इंजीनियरी श्री ए के मित्तल जी से अनुरोध करती हूँ कि वे माननीय रेल मंत्री जी का स्वागत प्लांटर देकर करें। माननीय रेल मंत्री श्री सुरेश प्रभु जी। आज के कार्यक्रम का शुभारंभ कर रहे हैं दीप प्रज्वलन के साथ। मैं आज के समारोह के मुख्य अतिथि माननीय रेल मंत्री जी, अध्यक्ष रेलवे बोर्ड, सदस्य इंजीनियरी तथा डायस पर उपस्थित अन्य अधिकारियों से अनुरोध करती हूं कि वे दीप प्रज्वलित कर आज के कार्यक्रम का शुभारंभ करें। कार्यक्रम को आगे बढ़ाते हुए अब मैं माननीय रेल मंत्री जी से अनुरोध करती हूँ कि वे कृपया कुछ बुक्स का विमोचन अपने कर कमलों से करें। बिजनेस प्लान ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, मैं रेल परिवार के मुखिया माननीय रेल मंत्री जी से अनुरोध करती हूँ कि वे कृपया इस अवसर पर हमारा मार्गदर्शन करें। माननीय रेल मंत्री श्री सुरेश प्रभाकर प्रभु जी।
आई कैनॉट से मित्तल, आई शुड से मित्तल्स, बिकॉज़ आई कैन सी थ्री मित्तल स्टैंडिंग हियर। Chairman Railway Board, Member Engineering, all these colleagues, all the technical experts who are gathered from different parts of India, few of you have come from different parts of world, and friends. Normally, the politicians, the ministers, job is to learn from such seminars. It is not to give any advice. And luckily, the railways, Indian Railways, has remained a very professional organization, which has a railway board consisting of professionals drawn from different fields. They meet often, they discuss and debate many issues, and it's a very good system in which policy making as well as implementation is done through a very professional way of doing it. And our endeavor has been in the last few years is to make it even more professional. And to achieve that, we are working on building up professional skills, inducting people who can add value to this organization, making sure that the decision making of the entire organization is done in such a way that at professional level, whether it's a general manager, whether it's DRM, whether it's a railway board, the decisions are taken at that level. And to achieve that, we have taken a number of administrative and other measures, which I don't want to dwell upon. But having done that, now the key element of the organization would be that it should remain a continuously learning organization. It must understand the global trends. We should try to better the global trends, because some of the issues that we face in India are very unique to our country. So we should not expect other parts of the world to offer us any advice or ideas. We should try to develop our own solution to the problem that we face. And in this context, an organization like this must constantly endeavor to engage with outsiders not just within the organization, but those who are working within the country, outside on various issues, and try to learn and absorb the knowledge and try to develop our own ideas. And I'm sure this seminar will achieve the same objective. And I wish to congratulate all of you, particularly those 20 presenters of papers who have come and offered some advice on technical issues. I think Indian Railways has to do a lot of catching up. When we started the railways more than 150 years ago, since then, there has been a huge exponential increase in the traffic. But unfortunately, the infrastructure growth couldn't keep pace with that. And in a way, if you want to simplify the problem of the railways that is facing today, it's that we did not cater to the growing demand. Therefore, we lost some customers like freight customers. The infrastructure got overstretched and causing several challenges on safety, on efficiency, on delivery. And all of this, therefore, has now resulted into the problems of railway today. So, therefore, we need to do a lot of catching up. We must try to very quickly try to increase the infrastructure so that we can regain the lost nodal share. We also improve the efficiency of operation. And even in passengers, we may think that passenger no other choice, but that is also changing very fast. People will definitely find some other alternatives, and we are seeing the premium segment of the railways. We are also facing a lot of stiff competition from other modes of transportation. So catching up would mean that we'll have to increase the speed of implementation. We'll have to get new management techniques to implement it, but also technological ideas to actually put into reality. So if we are doing about 3 kilometers a day, and that would probably take us to one level of achieving some milestone, by then the traffic demand would increase even more. So forget catching up with the past. If we continue with the same speed that we are doing about 3 years ago, then probably we would be losing more and we will be accentuating a problem even more than what it is today. So therefore, we have to increase the speed of implementation and get technology to do that. So whatever needs to be done managerially can be managed within the railway board, but trying to get technology is something which we really need to work with others. And we are very happy to see that now we are trying to absorb new technologies for track, laying a new tracks, track maintenance, finding out the technological flaws as it happens over a period of time because of the usage, and understanding how to fix it in the shortest possible time. So all elements of railway operations needs a technological upgradation. And essentially, which is basically the interface between track and the rolling stock. So both needs completely revamping. So rolling stock, of course, we are trying to work on separately. But on tracks, which is the today's seminar topic, how do you get best technologies for track? And I'm sure end of the day, we'll definitely would have learned. And my request to my colleagues only will be that what we have learned, we should try to implement in the shortest possible time. So not only implement more track laying, but implement the ideas that we get. Recently, we have been organizing a number of roundtables to have an interface with the outside world. And one of them was a very excellent roundtable was on technology, wherein we could get a lot of new ideas from global players. I think that also we are trying to integrate into this. Partly, some of these ideas that will be discussed here would have also been discussed at that place. But laying tracks at a faster pace is absolutely necessity. I mean, there is no choice. This is something which has to be happen at a much faster rate. And luckily, we have a lot of technologies available today. Even in India, dedicated freight corridor, which is one of the very ambitious program of our railways, we are trying to implement it through the automatic track laying machine. But there could be even better options. And therefore, we should try to do that. And I am very sure that collectively if we plan, we can start putting it up very soon. The idea would be that we should try to not only double, not only triple, but even go higher for implementing new projects. And to do that, technological option is the only way it can happen faster. Because human effort will be necessary, but it can take you this far, but not beyond. So technology and human effort put together, we can achieve even a faster goal, and that's what we really need to do. Other element, and I'm sure you are all experts, so I don't want to dwell upon how technology will work, but other aspect will be also the materials that we use in tracks. I think that is going to be a major issue that we really need to think about very seriously. Because material management is going to be a major challenge, not for railways, not only for any particular activity, but for any activity that we carry out in the world today, we should understand the implications of availability of material, which is going to be one of the most limiting factors for planning. And therefore, globally, we realized it much earlier. So we started working on nanotechnology. And that is helping some sectors of the economic and social activities. But I think in railways, we need to think about materials, what we use and what goes into the track making or track laying has to be very seriously thought about. Because even ballast may not be available. And even now, I'm not sure whether you face that problem or not. But we will definitely face this severe challenge over a period of time in terms of materials as a constraint for laying of new tracks. And therefore, while we discuss technology on one side, we should look at the natural resources, which will be one of the contributing factors to development, but also could be a limiting reason for not having faster growth. And that's something which also need to be thought about. So I think right now you must focus on that as well while we discuss the technologies, and must have a separate cell to think about it. And I'm sure all of this will lead to, over a period of time, marrying of both natural resources, technology, human resources will result into a better output. I'm sure about that. While we do this, for the big challenge we always face is that if you use technology, then we displace people from maintaining it or putting up the lines. Because railways is, and particularly the railway line construction, maintenance, safety, monitoring of its operation, which the trackmen do, all of this is extremely labor intensive. So inevitably, to achieve the speed, as I said, there is no choice. We have to do it is to bring in more technology and mechanization. But what do you deal with displacement of people that will happen result of this? So I'm very happy that we are working on one innovative way of doing it is to start skill development program in which we'll be able to take more people on board and actually trying to work on that. But I think we really need to think about innovative ideas even to do that, because social implications also cannot be ignored. And therefore, while we must focus on technology, we must implement the speed of implementation, and that inevitably will result into some displacement. How we can redeploy them into some other sectors in the same organization, same activity, is something we need to think about. For example, tree plantation is one activity. It will be source, will not be do, will be doing that, will add value to the railways, over a period of time will happen, but something like this has to be thought. But I'm very happy that today we have launched a program for diploma, which will be offered for the skill development, as well as it will really result into that. I think we really need to think about, and this is what I've been talking to my colleagues in the railway board for a while, is how do you bring in a research and development center within the railways. This one seminar is a one-off event. But on an ongoing basis, we must focus on some of the areas which are of critical importance to us, even in construction technology. How do you have a permanent research and development center, which need not necessarily be a big activity, big building, so many people. That center can coordinate with so many research organizations and the educational institutions, which I already made a beginning. We have started working with several IITs, and one of the IIT, in fact, we are working on material management, IIT BHU, I think, if I am not mistaken. And therefore, the idea, and that also we started in the last few years, exactly for the same reason. But the idea would be, not necessarily we have to create another infrastructure, another manpower. What we can do is this center will be identify every year critical areas in which we really need to focus on and get new R&D ideas globally and try to integrate them into our day-to-day management of this. In fact, we are trying to think about it. For example, I was in Bangalore the other day, and a general manager was telling me that while we are setting up new lines and trying to bring more traffic into the city, now the city station itself is so congested, so we cannot do anything. I said, why cannot you put up elevated stations or go underground and try to make a station? So I think these are the ideas which we'll have to think about to address some of the challenges which are coming. So it is not enough that we can do high track laying. That will happen, but that might bring in more traffic into the station, which will create even more problems. And therefore, we really need to think about integrated ideas and technologies to deal with such issues. So I think we, and obviously the seminar of this kind can focus only on few topics, what you are rightly doing. But I'm saying the broader picture would be that how do you get this integrated solution for the movement? Because movement of traffic would mean that not movement only up to the city, the terminating point, but it should keep flowing all the time, and that's what is going to be some of the challenge. So research and development, this is one small example I gave, but of different kinds really need to be thought about very seriously. Also, we need to standardize most of the material. We should try to use as much prefabricated material as much as possible so that we can put it up at a faster pace. I'm sure they would be being doing, but I think we really need to revisit many of the issues. The biggest problem any human being faces anytime is his own past, because we think my experience is such that is giving me some strength. But your experience becomes your biggest enemy, because you think that I have done it for so many years, how can it be wrong? So that is a problem everybody faces. And even organizations like railways will say, 150 years we have been doing it, how can it be wrong? So what we are doing in 150 years was good for 150 years, but now it is 151st year. So we must find out what is relevant for 151st year. And if that is the case, that only 150 years could be the only criteria, then the railway would never have been developed in the world to begin with. Because even that person would have said, what is railway? We have 150 years, we are doing horse-drawn carts and everything. Why shouldn't it be railway? So they changed it. That's why railway is there. If the change brought the railway into reality. So therefore, change in railways working is also necessary to take railways to a newer level. So just thinking that we have done it for so many years, so it has to be right, is true in some way, but cannot be right in all times. And therefore, we need to revisit all the issues. Technical seminars provide us this opportunity, but I think we need permanent center, like an R&D center, for each of the activity that railways does, particularly in the construction, because this is going to be a very important development for future. As you must have seen in the film, we have increased the capital expenditure in the railways significantly higher than what it was. 2,75,000 crores for the railways in the last 2.5-3 years is a significant increase than what we are doing today. And in fact, if you add to it some of the other tertiary investment that are going to come into the railways by somebody manufacturing locomotives, somebody trying to develop stations, somebody a high-speed railway project, which is a standalone project, all of that put together in the railway network as a whole, the investment is manifold, even unimaginable only about 3 years ago. And I think therefore we need to bring new ideas, new technologies, constantly upgrade, and what we upgrade has to be constantly again revisited, because we should not think now I've done it, now 10 years I will not do anything. I think every day will be the day in which we'll need to do introspection, so I hope we'll do that. Technical seminar will provide a stimulus to make that happen. So thank you very much. Congratulations once again. I again wish to congratulate Mr. Mittal and all his team members for bringing together such a distinguished lot of people. And I think this is a very important thing, is that constantly learning and through such technical seminar is something which will help us a long way. So congratulations to all of you. Thank you very much.